truly understanding the complexity and power of the mirror modifier. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about a powerhouse modifier that is the mirror modifier. It is usually said that it is extremely simple, but in my book, I would say it's deceptively simple, as it can get quite complicated. Starting from a fresh Blender file, let's go ahead, invert our selection as we go and explore the mirror modifier. So with our default cube here, I'm going to take it into edit mode and I'm going to subdivide it once. I'm then going to grab this side of the vertices and I'm going to go ahead and delete them. As you can imagine, the mirror modifier mirrors our mesh. So let's go straight to it, modifier shelf, here it is, mirror, done. It has just mirrored our mesh. Now, it might confuse you a little bit how exactly this mirroring is going on, because the way that I saw this when I first joined into Blender was going, okay, well, it's just mirrored it on the Y direction. But here it says X, so what's going on? That's the key. It is mirrored on the X axis direction. It hasn't used the X axis as a mirror. I hope that makes sense, because if you were to use the Y axis as the mirror, you would get this result, so to speak. Okay, so now what's going to happen if I move this? Nothing. Why is that? Well, the reason why is fundamentally the origin point is what controls the mirroring. It is the axis of the origin point that deals with that. So if we were to go ahead into our options, and we go to our tools, we've got options, transforms, origins. If we were to move our origin point, you can see that moves our mirroring point. Now, just for the sake of this example, I want to bring something that's a little bit more visual to see this whole idea of mirroring. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go ahead and bring in a circle. Let's bring in a mesh circle. Let's make this circle nice and big. So let's add some, make it nice and big. Great. I'm then going to grab the circle. I'm going to rotate it on the Y by 90 degrees. But very important here is that I need to make sure that my Y is set back down to zero. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my rotation. Okay, so now with that set, I can actually set an object to be my actual mirror. So let's go here, mirror my circle. So the circle has an origin point. And by the way, here's a quick tip, 3D cursor out. Remember, this is the origin of creation. You can create these things called empties. They're basically just sort of the same as this circle, but different. They're not mesh. And they have an origin point too. So you could use these as your mirror location as well. But anyway, with this circle, we now know that this is our mirror. So let's go into edit mode. And the whole idea of mirroring is that it speeds up your workflow when you have to do the same thing on the other side. So we could go here, we could extrude this. And as you can see, it's working on the other side. Okay, fantastic. Now what's going on if I go here into my vertex selection and I select this vertex and then I move it that way? Okay, that's a little bit broken. That shouldn't be able to do that because technically this is my mirror. My mirror is very much a physical thing and I don't want to break the mirroring unless this is the result that you're wanting. Now, there is something for that and that is called clipping. So let's go ahead, let's turn on clipping. Now, keep in mind that clipping has a few weird little tricks. So first of all, if we go ahead and try and move this right this minute, you're not going to be able to. This is because this vertex is perfectly in the center of our axis of mirroring. So if we turn off our clipping now, we'll be able to move this. And then if we turn our clipping back on, you will see the real thing that clipping does. So if I go ahead and move it now, you can't go to the other side of the mirror. Now, another thing to be careful of is that if you have clipping off and you move to the other side and then you turn clipping back on, you will not be able to get past the mirror. You can think of it as if you're stuck in the mirror dimension, so to speak. So there's something to keep in mind. Now, something along to go with clipping is this whole idea of this merge. Now, what exactly is this merge? This merge, as you can imagine, it's pretty much the same as our auto merge. So any vertices that are close enough to each other, so right here, 0.001 millimeters, they are going to merge. And how are they merging? Because is this mesh over here? Yes, it is. Because if you go into wireframe mode, there is wireframe there. So there is technically mesh there, but you can't interact with it. It's just being mirrored. Okay, so now with that said, let's go ahead and figure out this idea that there's more axes to mirror on. So let's go here and let's delete this half of our mesh. So with this half deleted, you can see that we're missing half our mesh. Now, what direction do we need to mirror on to go ahead and create that mesh on the other side? That's right, it would be on the y-axis. And believe it or not, there is exactly the same for the z-axis. So I'll just turn on the z-axis here. So we've got our z-axis here. So if we want, we could even delete this face. This is right here. And we can turn on our z mirroring as well. So that means you can do work on just one corner and it will do the exact same on all the rest. So let's go ahead, let's do that. Let's do a nice little inset here and an extrusion upwards, and you can see what's happening right this minute. Now, in all honesty, that there is pretty much everything there is to do with the mirror tool. Yes, there's this thing called bisect and flip. I have tried for the life of me to figure out how to use these, but I have no idea, really no idea. So if anybody knows, please leave me a comment down below because I would love to understand these. So let's undo this just a little bit to the point that we have this right here, because I want to get a concept across to you as well. Just be aware that when you're mirroring, it might not be the same sort of idea that you're thinking. You're now speaking about mirrors. So if we go ahead and we move this, and let's move this on the X down this way. Let's also make sure that I'm not mirroring on all these axes. I just want to do it on the X. If you wanted to mirror like a 90 degree, you can do that using this whole concept of a mirror. But do keep in mind that the way that this is done is not your usual way of thinking. Oh, I want to move something 90 degrees. I'll move it 90 degrees. No, this works very much like a real world mirror. So if you go ahead and you do a rotation on the Z, you can see that if you did 90 degrees, it's going to go all the way back round. It's got to be 45 degrees, because 45 degrees, if you think about it, right there, that would be considered a 90 degrees from the location of mirroring. So that's just something to point out. Anyway, so from here, let's go take a look at mirroring in a real world situation. So here we are in the real world example, and as you can see, we need to recreate this Vive controller holder. So let's hide this, and you can see, okay, this is what we're trying to create. Oh look, there's some extra little things here. It looks like there's some Booleans going on. So let's go and sort that out. Our beginning mesh is here, and by the way, by no means is this mesh any good whatsoever. This is, quite frankly, can happen very often if you go and do limited dissolves and you forget how things are put together and it just gets messy. There's a lot of work here to create this mesh to be absolutely perfect, but at the same time, it's probably also 3D printable still. All right then, so from here, let's go and talk about this mirror. So go and try it out. The link is down in the description for this file, and let's get on with the solution right now. So here we go. Let's first add a loop cut right here, because this is actually the very center. If you take a look from the top, you will see that that is dead on the y-axis. So this is how I've created it to make life a little bit easier for you. So now we're going to go and do some face selecting. We're going to select these faces right there, and then we're going to delete the vertices associated with that face. So then we have this open mesh here, and remember, it's open mesh because we can see that red, and we never want to really be able to see red. So with that there, it's as simple as going ahead. We can see that our origin point is already in the right place. So let's just go ahead and add a mirror modifier. We We add that mirror modifier, and there you have it. It's that powerful. Now, if we really want, we can go ahead and go here and apply it. But you know what? Let's go and talk about the mirroring that's going on down here. So we need to mirror this object around because I don't feel like copying this three times over and then, oh God, it's going to be a real pain. So let's go ahead and let's see. We need a middle point for the base. Well, right up here, there isn't one because there's all that mesh there. And the real reason why I need this middle point is to go ahead and use my 3D cursor to create some geometry. Now, right here, there is an edge that goes in the middle and all the way across. I'm going to use that. I'm going to move my 3D cursor to the selected, which brings it to the middle of that. Great. And now I'm going to go and create my first empty. So let's go here, out of edit mode. Let's create an empty, a planes empty. A nice big one here. We're going to move it up on the Z. Be careful not to move it on the Y or the X. All right, there we go. That's exactly where I want it. Great. So this is going to be our mirroring origin point. So I'm going to go to our little cut cube here. And I'm going to go add a modifier to it. And let's go, hey, I'm wanting to put a mirror. And you're going to mirror from this right here, that empty. Okay, so it's mirroring across to there. Well, technically I don't need that. I only need it to mirror on the Y direction. So let's remove that there. And then we are gonna go from here to this one here. We're gonna use our control minus our bool tool. Hey, but what's going on? Why hasn't that mirrored over there? Once again, remember, we're working with modifiers now. Our stack is incredibly important. So right this minute, we have our mirroring and then we have our bool. Well, technically, I don't want that that way. I want to mirror my Boolean as well. So let's go ahead and just change the stack order and you'll see that the holes now appear over on the mirror. Now, of course, once this is all done, we can go over to our mesh here. We can just say apply all, and there we have now this lovely mesh, not so lovely as well, but it's there and it's made, and that's the key element of it. Well done for getting through the mirror modifier. As you can see, it can be very simple, but also quite complicated if you don't quite understand the terminology and the way that it's referring to itself. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it's the reason why I'm able to create these videos right here for free for everyone. And if you're enjoying the videos that I'm making and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.